Hi, welcome. This is a 30-minute pop ride, no weights, and we won't be going any faster than 110 RPMs. You can do the entire ride in the saddle if you want. Listen to your body, do what's best for you. So I would say this would be like a beginner to moderate ride, but you could make it an advanced ride. It really depends on the resistance you use and whether you're in or out of the saddle. You make any class as easy or as hard as you want, okay? So with that being said, we are gonna start in the saddle, right or left leg. We're just gonna go ahead and find this beat. You're gonna be looking at about 100 RPMs here. So scoot your butt back. You're on the widest portion of the saddle right here. And you're looking at 100 RPMs. Once you've done that, reach down and add some resistance so that it feels like you're pushing against something and not that the flywheel is doing all the work, okay? Drop your elbows. Good. Elbows go straight down. Yes. So this is like the crunch, but the press is what we do when we're out of the stack. We have all the way at the end, at third. Keep it. Imagine how good you're gonna feel at the end of this ride. You got blood flowing, you're gonna be smarter, endorphins flowing, abs tight, add a little more resistance right here. See ya. If I ever ask for you to add resistance and it causes you to slow down, don't add it, reach out. This is going to be a jog at 80. So we go a little bit faster, just a slow, gradual ramp up on speed. Moving in and out of the saddle here if you need to. Again, you're right here. Keep an eye. If you don't have a computer, watch my legs. Match your legs up with mine. And then you'll be right at the cadence. Yeah.
And then we ride on the mothership. Ride. Hop on the mothership and we ride with the lies. Make your dreams flip. Get the beats knocking, make your heart skip.
And you gotta place. Mothership, two right, two left.
Hop on the mothership and we ride.
Sweet. Level up, add a little bit more. I'm still feeling a little bit bouncy, so I want to add some support to the wheel, making sure that I'm supporting my legs and my joints.
I'm on a supernova tip when I let it rip. These beats that I flip make it see and drip. I'm the captain of the vibe, time to let your mind slip. Crystallize, make your dreams flip. Get the beats.
Remember to stay connected with your breath. If your mind ever starts to wander, you simply reach down, you add more. Okay, from the top, two right, two left. Squeeze your abs find it over here. You add some more resistance. Between 63 and 65 RPMs. So give it another big turn up. Take the bounce out. So you lower your center of gravity. Good, no bounce. Try not to slow too far down with your RPMs. Makes it really easy. You're not into easy. Side to side. Hips and shoulders moving together. Corners, take it back. Give me a kiss. Breathe. Yeah. Good. Let that good energy in. Back for four. Bring it up. We got our first attack coming up. You're going to pick up your pace, and it better feel like you're running up a hill. Ready? 3, 2, 1, push. Go. You're no faster than 85 RPMs. If you're faster than me, you better add some resistance. Keep it going, come on. Fight through the discomfort. Outlast the discomfort. I know you can. That's how you get stronger. On the beat, left leg. Great. Good. So your body did well with that. Your body adapts. You've got to continue to bring the challenge. We never get complacent, so turn it up. Side to side. How much you increase your resistance depends on how you're feeling today. But we have about commitment. Corners back. That we are always working harder than we did the last time we were on the bike. Right? There are no plateaus when you continue to push. I got your back. Pull back in the saddle. Let's push right here. Come on. It's so much harder in the saddle. Honestly. Ha. Come on. It's just your legs doing the work. Keep that. Your breath is going to help you stay oxygenated. You have more power. 8 seconds. 6. Come on. 4. 2. Stand up. Left leg go. So your mirror image of me when I pull that left is actually my right. So, right here, left foot down. Corners back, take it back. Hips and shoulders move together, you're not all over the place. Tight, control. Straight back for 4. Yes. Oh, we gotta add some more. Hold it right here. Inhale. Exhale. Out of the saddle. Push. Let's go. It's these high intensity intervals that are going to change your body, that are going to help keep you a fuel burning machine for the rest of the day. Whether you're sitting at your desk, you're taking a nap, you do these intervals, your metabolism increases, right? So lean into them. Learn to love them. On the beat. Whew. Good. Okay, we move back over to the right leg. Feel your resistance back. We'll start in the saddle. Get a sense for where you're at. I believe this is about 95 RPMs, so you feel better here. Just make sure you have more resistance.
It's closing time, so leave with me again.
Happy songs. Just love singing to them. Reach out, rise up. Here it is. Two right, two elbow, and then a tap press twice. Right, left, tap press, tap press. Just imagine the Jonas Brothers are riding right alongside you, right? Reach out. From the top, here we go.
Kind of exciting, right?
Now you got this whole day ahead. of you, when you have that in mind, what are the things that you're going to do so that when you rest your head tonight, you feel satisfied? You feel good about how you spent your time on this planet with the people in your life, right? Rise up. Say yes. Say yes to all the good things that life has to offer because you deserve them. Light it up. Push. Go. Yes! I feel it! Come on, push! In the saddle, keep your push right here. Good. I feel like I can add something else. Will you join me? Let's do it. Come on. The shoulders stay down. Our biggest hill, right leg. Let's go. Right, left. So, this being your heaviest hill, you want to add the thickness, add the resistance to the wheel by turning right. Now, I see this, and I have to encourage a lot of people because they're afraid to add resistance. In the same token, I have those riders that are going to go hang out every class. Only thing I ask, you're staying right at 58 to 60 RPMs. You're dropping below that, you've got too much resistance on it, okay? It's about learning to finesse the wheel, and you'll get better at it, and it'll make sense. Have a seat, push. Right? Temporary discomfort, long-term satisfaction. Right here, work for it. It's the things that we work hard for that are worth having. Stand up. Back on the beat. Just catch your breath before we add anything else. So out of the saddle is really the only time that your hands are going to be out here. Otherwise, you're too far extended. So we got one push toward the other. And that's how we move. So we move forward, one step at a time. You get closer to your goals, closer to where you want to be. Okay, next push. Entirely in the saddle. Ready, let's go. So you're extending your power down right to your, and you're pulling that good energy up right towards your heart. Okay, push and pull. Yes. Come on. 2, 1, on the beat, right. Rise up. More effort involved, right? You're starting to feel your upper body wants to help with the amount of resistance you have on the wheel. Level up. Okay. A good coach tells you what to expect. The last push, twice as long. Okay? I'm right here with you. I got your back. We're going to do it together. There's nothing that frustrates me more than taking a class and watching the instructor stand there and yell at me and tell me to go. I'm like, bitch, get out of the way. What are you talking about? I've done it before, so I can say that. Ah, let's go, push. Pull your knees up. Feel the tops of your shoes with your feet. Close your eyes. Today is the day you have a breakthrough. Yes. Come on. Have a seat. Keep your push. Halfway. Come on, push and pull. Create space between your ears and your shoulders. Yes. All out. All out, baby. Ha. Pull back. You should be breathless. Yes, yes. And then, if
You should get all off. Find your support again.
We be in the same time.
Right or left leg.
Look at the timeline. Seeing all the rainbows.
Get yourself back to a place where you're breathing. It's short, but you're not panting and gasping for air, right?
I'm a couple hundred miles from Japan. I was thinking I could not take your heart.
108. It's your fastest song in this ride. Last song in the ride. Ready. Reach out to third. Stand up. Go. You can vibe with it. So you keep practicing at this range of RPM. You start to get more confident, and it feels good for you. You start to push on the 128s, right? And if that's not your jam, that's totally awesome too. My main goal is to provide a ride for you that makes you smile, makes you feel successful and good. Stand up. Yeah. Dance with me to right. Go. Tiny movement. Use your stability muscles to minimize the movement. Saddle. Yeah. So, I intentionally created a pattern here. This is just like the last song. Your last push is twice as long. You're welcome. Okay, but we got a big finish, right? This is your celebration. It's your victory lap. Right? And if you're not at 108, find what feels fast for you. It's not about perfection. Okay? Your best efforts. You ready? Single. Have a seat. Beautiful. Ha. Legs stay moving. So, I hope you feel incredible. Your energy picked up. I find, don't get me wrong, I love coffee, but I find even after like a short session, I feel like I have so much more energy. I'm in a better mood. It just changes everything, right? Take your right ear to your shoulder, left hand reaches under the saddle, or you just extend your the palm of your hand towards the floor. Inhale. This all the time. This is not nearly enough stretching for the work we do on the bike. Your legs are still moving, so you never want to stop abruptly, especially if you're new on your fitness journey. You want to make sure that your heart is able to just slow down naturally and smoothly. So if your heart is still beating pretty quickly, keep your legs moving and follow this stretch later on when you're better. Okay. On stretch. Bring your leg up, inhale, reach up, good. Give your leg a big old hug right here. So just give your leg a hug, maybe massage your calf a little bit. Say thank you, leg, for working so hard. You're awesome. Good. And then rotate your ankle both directions. Clip back in and switch legs. If you're new to clipping in, you don't have to clip all the way back in. Just make sure that you're secure while you're doing these stretches. Quad stretch first. Extend up. Deep breath in. Exhale out. Just think about something that you're really grateful for today, right? You make gratitude a habit,
your whole world changes.
Big hug here.
Massage on the calf, little ankle roll, and then we hop off the bike. I finish all of my classes with the power pose. If you want to know more about it, you can always look up the TED talk. I think I'm going to have to add that in my comments or something so it's an easy reference. But when you are in your power pose, essentially you are standing like your favorite superhero. So you stand tall, confident, shoulders on your back, your chest is open, your palms are open to receive good energy, and you just connect. You connect with your energy, you connect with the earth, feeling grounded and centered. And by doing this for just a few moments, it changes the chemistry in your brain and in your body, and it provides more confidence and it provides more courage. So just know whenever you need that, that it's always within you. You just have to remember to tap into it, right? Deep breath in. Let's reach up with gratitude. Capture that beautiful energy. Pull it to your heart. Keep it with you. Share it with others. I appreciate you so much. Thanks for riding with me.